Well, in a key move towards impeaching Donald Trump, the Democratic-controlled US House Judiciary Committee has revealed the charges against the president. ABC correspondent Mona Kosar Abdi is on Capitol Hill and joins us now with the latest. Good morning. Can you explain these articles of impeachment for us?
Right, so Haley, we're watching history unfold in real time here, because only the fourth time in the history of this country has Congress deployed its most powerful tool under the Constitution, which is unveiling these articles of impeachment. To break it down for you, there's two specific articles. It is abuse of power and obstruction of Congress. Now, the abuse of power stems from allegations that the president pressured the president of Ukraine for political purposes. He pressured President Zelensky to open an investigation, or at least announce an investigation into his political rival Joe Biden and his son Hunter Biden in exchange, and he leveraged nearly $400 million in military aid. And the obstruction of Congress comes from the fact that Democrats say that the president and the White House has gone out of its way to prevent some senior officials from testifying. Because to break it down for you, the Democratic-led House Intelligence Committee released a 300-page report, and in it, they connect the Ukraine scandal to the Vice President of the United States. They connect it to the President's Secretary of State and his acting Chief of Staff. And so they say that the President and the White House has made a concerted effort to block and make this investigation as hard as possible for the House. But the President has said that he's not interested in participating in the impeachment proceedings. Just this morning, he used a familiar refrain, again calling it a witch hunt, Haley.
Is there any reason why there hasn't been an obstruction of justice charge relating to the Robert Mueller investigation into Russian interference?
So it seems that when House Speaker Nancy Pelosi was asked about it, if they're going to include anything from the Mueller investigation, she kind of brushed it off and dismissed it. It seems that Democrats want to distinguish the two, because, again, after the Mueller investigation, it seemed that House Speaker Nancy Pelosi wasn't convinced enough to go ahead and launch an impeachment inquiry. She said the president just wasn't worth it and that Democrats were focused on the 2020 election. But then when the New York Times released that article saying that there was evidence that the president had pressured Ukraine for political purposes, that is where she said that in America, no one is above the law. And that was late September when she launched the impeachment inquiry. Now, the Republican argument is that Democrats are afraid that they can't beat Donald Trump in the general election come November 2020. And that is why they've been moving through this process as fast as possible, because we're likely to see a full House vote on impeachment as soon as likely before Christmas. And so President Trump can be impeached before the end of the year. But it seems the president himself on Twitter was encouraging Democrats to move through this process as fast as possible. He said, if you're going to impeach me, do it now fast, because he's banking on the trial that will be held in the Republican-controlled Senate. And it seems that the White House strategy right now is to prepare their defense for that trial that will likely take place in January. And that is why we saw the White House participate in none of the impeachment hearings and the proceedings as well, Haley.
You just mentioned that the Republicans control the Senate. How likely is it that this impeachment could lead to Trump being removed from office?
As of right now, it doesn't seem likely at all, because there are some Senate Democrats as well who are still on the fence about this. And so while it's almost certain that the president will be impeached in the House, in the Senate, it's a little bit more tricky. And also what's important to note is that both Republicans and Democrats in the Senate are looking to move through this process in the Senate trial, as fast as possible, because not only is the State of the Union being held in January, but also you have three of the Democratic senators who will act as jurors in this trial. They're on the campaign trail. And so it doesn't look good politically. The political optics don't look good for Democrats if they're dealing with trying to beat Donald Trump in the 2020 election and trying to also remove him from office. So it seems that most of this will wrap up in January, but it doesn't look likely that he will be removed from office.
Thank you so much for your time this morning. That is Mona Kosar Abdi, our ABC correspondent live in Capitol Hill.
How good is Mona? We like crossing to Mona.
We love.
We'd like you on every day, Mona. That's it's trouble for you.
I will.
Thanks, Mona.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.